So far in this series, we walked through the ins and outs of heat pump heating and cooling, from the benefits to the science. But this technology can also be used to power other appliances in your home. For instance, your refrigerator is actually a heat pump. But here I'm thinking about two other things: heat pump hot water heaters and heat pump dryers. They use less energy than their conventional cousins, and although they've been around for years, they're now starting to get more popular in the US. Hi, I'm Alexis Dahl, a science journalist in Michigan's Upper Peninsula. And when it comes to efficiency, cost, and more, here's what you need to know about these other heat pump appliances. Let's start with water heaters, because they can account for about 14 to 18% of the average utility bill. To get your shower running at your favorite temperature, conventional water heaters generate heat. They might do this by burning gas, propane, or fuel oil, or by heating a coil using electricity. That last option is called electric resistance heating. Heat pump water heaters also run on electricity, but they use that energy in a more efficient way. Instead of generating heat, they move heat from the air, the ground, or a water source into the water inside your unit's storage tank. There are lots of ways to put together a system like this. So for this example, let's use a water heater that's pulling its heat from the air around it. First, a fan blows air over evaporator coils, which are filled with a really cold refrigerant. If you've watched our other videos, you'll remember that refrigerant helps move heat from one part of this system to another, like a delivery driver. The refrigerant absorbs heat from the air, then moves into the unit's compressor, which, like the name says, compresses the refrigerant to raise its temperature even more. Then the hot refrigerant heads into the condenser coils, which are wrapped around the water tank. The cooler water in the tank absorbs heat from the hot coils, and before you know it, your water is nice and toasty and ready to fill your bathtub. So basically, these water heaters take heat from the air around them, use a compressor to warm it up, and then put that heat into your water tank. The nice thing is, you don't need to have a heat pump HVAC system to get a heat pump water heater. You can just swap out your existing unit for a heat pump version. Or you could even retrofit your conventional water heater with a heat pump. If you're looking to really boost your home's efficiency, you could also go all in and get a 3-in-1 heat pump system that handles your HVAC and your water heating needs. Now, these water heaters are more expensive upfront, but they can also work 1 to 5 years longer than their conventional counterparts, and they can be 2 to 3 times more efficient. That can save you several $100s per year. Those savings can offset your upfront purchase costs in as little as about 3 years for a family of 4. And if you buy an Energy Star certified heat pump water heater, that could qualify you for utility, state, and federal programs that cover part of your purchase and installation. But speaking of installation, here's something to know. Whatever heat pump system you choose, you'll need to install it in a space of at least 450 cubic feet, about the size of an 8x8 foot utility room. And many manufacturers recommend at least 700 to 800 cubic feet. Having space helps heat pumps work properly by giving them access to the surrounding air. Also, know that these units are less efficient if they're somewhere chilly. They work best in spaces at or above 40 degrees Fahrenheit. Remember that they're pulling heat from the air around them, so it helps if there's some warm air for them to work with. That said, most of these water heaters are hybrids that include an electric resistance heating element. So if, say, your basement gets extra cold during the winter, your water heater can automatically switch to that backup element. It can also step in to heat hot water more quickly during times of high use, like when your whole family needs to shower after a day on the trails. Finally, two more things to keep in mind. As a bonus, heat pump water heaters also dehumidify the space they're in, which means they could replace your standalone dehumidifier if you have one. And last thing, they do cool the area around them by about 2 to 5 degrees Fahrenheit. That means your heating system might have to do a little more work in the winter, but there's less load on your cooling system in the summer. So that's water heaters. They use less energy, and if you pair them with renewable energy, like solar, hydroelectric, or wind power, you can reduce your impact on the environment even more. But this isn't the only place where heat pumps can make your home more efficient and eco-friendly. Some clothes dryers also use this technology to bring you fluffy laundry. Much like conventional water heaters, conventional dryers generate heat. They use electricity, natural gas, or propane to warm air, then move that air over your clothes to evaporate moisture and get them dry. Then that humid air gets vented outside, and the dryer heats new air in a continuous process until your clothes are ready. Heat pump dryers do things differently. The refrigerant in this system pulls heat from the surrounding room and is warmed up with a compressor. Coils full of hot refrigerant then warm air. That air goes into the dryer drum where it removes moisture from your wet clothes. Then, instead of sending that air outside, the dryer sends it over coils full of cold refrigerant, which removes its moisture without losing much of its heat. Finally, that still warm air goes back over the hot coils and into the drum to start the process again. The key is that they're recycling the hot air instead of continually warming up new air to keep the dry cycle going. Ultimately, these dryers use about 20 to 60% less energy than conventional electric dryers, which can translate to hundreds of dollars in savings over their lifetime. So again, although they are more expensive upfront, they can pay for themselves in the long run, and rebates and incentives can help you save even more. Also, because they recycle air, these dryers don't need to be vented to the outdoors. So long as you have a place to drain or dump water, you can put these things anywhere. Your new laundry room doesn't need to be near an outside wall. And no vent means one less hole in your house for air to escape, making your home more efficient. One thing to know is that these appliances do operate at lower temperatures, so it can take longer for them to dry your laundry. A full load might take 50 to 80 minutes. That's actually good news for your clothes. Less heat means less wear and tear on your threads over time, but it is something to consider if you're often doing multiple loads per day. Just make sure you're cleaning both the lint filter and the intake air filter. Unlike conventional dryers and their one filter, heat pump dryers have two. So, heat pumps aren't just for your HVAC system anymore. With this technology, water heaters and clothes dryers can do their jobs more efficiently. That can mean lower energy bills and reducing your carbon footprint too. Next up is the last episode in this series. I'm in Michigan's Upper Peninsula, and many of you might be too. And I have questions about how heat pumps work in our communities. Like, how reliable are they in a blizzard? Really? We'll get into these questions and more in our next episode. See you then. This educational heat pump video is brought to you by the Upper Peninsula Power Company's Energy Efficiency Program.